season of waiting, waiting for hope, peace, joy, and love of God to break into our lives anew through the story of the birth of Jesus and through acts of hope, peace, joy, and love. Today we light the third candle, the candle of joy. We wait. We wait not because we do not know the story of Jesus, and not because we are not already in God's care. We wait because to wait is to expect something more. To wait is to expect that the story of life and our hearts and our world will be new ways to bring change for Christian law. As we light the candle of joy, we remember the stories of God's loyalty to all creation. We give thanks for these, for the messengers, the apostles, prophets, artists, sages, faithful ones present in every age who bring us the good news of God's restoring love. And we shout with joy, trusting that God is with us and before us, and that joy will be born anew in us.
Today we come to reenact the glorious birth of Jesus. Births are an amazing thing, as we have been privileged to be part of some of our own Pilgrim baby births this year, with the birth of Hugo to Emily and Andy, Camille to Samantha and Chuck, Christopher to Jennifer and Nigel, Dash to Stephanie and Darius, and of course the proud grandma Lori, and just recently Cameron to Megan and Chris and the proud grandma Lynn. Shouts of joy. What a blessing for you and for us. In the first 2 weeks of Advent, we lit the candles of hope, peace, and today the candle of joy. The birth of Jesus is truly one of hope, peace, and surely joy. Today, as we shout for joy at the birth of Jesus, we also remember that Mary, Joseph, and the shepherds had shouts of confusion, of fear, and what do I do next? On that night, God, you were with them, as it is the same today. You are always with us, God, showing us the way, showing us that your love will guide us through those temporary moments of despair to those moments of great joy. Let us hear the story.
Imagine the stars in the sky, the countless constellation, the sprawling solar system, and among it, a little planet called Earth. God made all of these things, and all the people and inhabitants of our planet. Over 2,000 years ago, when we most needed him, God came down to us in the form of a baby to show us how life should be lived.
The story opens with a young woman in her home, a woman named Mary. Unless you look a bit deeper, there is nothing particularly remarkable about Mary. She was from a town called Nazareth, and she was engaged to be married to Joseph. But to God, she was very important. So important that God sent an angel down from heaven with a message for her.
Hello, Mary. You are very special. God is with you.
But Mary found it hard to understand why the angel had come to see her. She was just an ordinary woman. The angel saw that Mary was afraid and confused, so the angel said,
"Do not be afraid. God is very pleased with you. You have been chosen to be the mother of God's child, and will name the baby Jesus. He will be called the Son of the Most High."
I understand how this can be, for Joseph, who I am to Mary, will feel. But I am a servant of God, so I believe it will happen, as you have said.
Thank you.
had a dream. In the dream, an angel came to him and told him that Mary was having a baby. Joseph was upset, but the angel told him that the baby was God's child. His name would be Jesus, and he would be the Savior that many people have been waiting a long time.
I believe and trust in my God, so I will marry Mary, and together we will prepare for the birth of Jesus.
Thank you.
Jesus was born. Mary wrapped the baby in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger filled with straw.
Thank you.
people in Bethlehem were asleep. They did not know that something important was happening. In the fields nearby, there were shepherds. They were watching their sheep when suddenly a great light appeared. The shepherds were terrified.
Do not be afraid, we bring you good news. Tonight your Savior was born. His name is Jesus. Look for the star. It is a special sign to mark the place where Jesus lay in the manger.
Then the sky was filled with angels singing and praising God. The shepherds were amazed.
Can this be true? Let's go see what the angel tells us about.
They looked for the star and they followed it into Bethlehem. They found Mary and Joseph and the baby Jesus. The baby was lying in a manger just as the angel had said. Please turn to page 144 for Hark the Herald's Angels Sing.
Messiah, Savior, a king born in the barest of palaces, yet they saw and fell down on their knees in adoration. Lord, they saw you and knew whom they had met. As we meet around the crib, the candle, or the Advent wreath this season, draw us into that stable in our imagination. In the quiet moments of prayer this Christmas, that brief oasis from the bustle of the world, bring alive to us the smell of the hay, the sound of the animals, the cry of the baby. Draw us close to our Savior, Messiah, as we bring the Messiah, as we bring the gold, myrrh, or frankincense, but the gift of our lives. As we gather this morning, let us give our offering with a renewed feeling of love and for you. Will the ushers please come forward? This morning as we rise as Love Came Down at Christmas on page 165. In the giving. God of grace, it is our delight and our devotion to give these gifts to you. All we are and all we have are yours alone. Accept this joyful offering as a token of our abiding love. Use it to bring peace, justice, and comfort and joy to all the world. Amen. May we sit. We invite you to go and get those from Gloria after worship service today. I'm sure you will enjoy them in your holiday time. They're also, this Tuesday is our longest night service, which begins at 6:30. I invite you all to come and be a part of that. And then
Tuesday. Right. Yes. Tuesday. Tuesday. And Friday, December 22nd, at 7:30, there will be a concert here, and we invite you to come at 7 o'clock. It is The Sounds of Christmas with Marsha Holmes. So we invite you to come and be a part of that also. And next Sunday, on Christmas Eve, we will have two services, one at the 11 o'clock time, and special lessons and carols at 4 o'clock, that we invite all you to come and be a part of that also. And Kathleen Loges has an announcement she would like to make. She can make it through the stable.
There's a very large sock at the back. Jeff is holding it up right now. It is almost filled, but we'd like to fill it all over again. We will be collecting even after the holidays. I don't think we're going to take our donation until January. So LGBTQ and A group would love to give your donations for clean new socks and underwear. Jeff kept trying to take his off this morning to put in there. But please, if you've forgotten so far, please bring those in. Adult sizes are preferred. Thank you so much.
Following the service today, there is a concert this afternoon, so any of those who are willing to help and stay and reconfigure for that concert, we would love to have you. Okay, before we lose our beautiful tableau here, we are going to close out our pageant this morning.
All those who came to see Jesus that night and the weeks to come knew that he was no ordinary baby. They knew God had special plans for him. They all went home praising God for all they had heard and seen.
Every year, we faithfully tell the story. People have been faithfully telling the story for over 2,000 years. That's a long time, and it's a lot of faith telling the storytellers.
So come, all ye faithful, and share this amazing story with all the world.